Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out.
Praise God, praise God. What a beautiful day. I thank God giving us life yet one more time. We thank God for loading us with benefit on a daily basis. We want to praise God for that. Today you are welcome to the open heavens. This is a beautiful, delicious meal, spiritual meal that we take in the morning before we set out in our various endeavors. And I'm trusting today that the Lord will do us good in Jesus' name. Now, today our Father in the Lord, Pastor Enoch Adeboye, has put together for us prayer items. You're going to love the topic of today's open heaven. It is prayers for the elders. Hallelujah. Prayers for the elders. I mean, fantastic. If we are going to sow this seed of prayers into the lives of our elders, oh, I guarantee you, you are going to reap the harvest of long life too. So because whatever you make happen for others, the Lord will definitely make happen for you. So get excited. We are going to pray. We're going to trust God for our elders. Elders in our families, elders in our churches, elders in our communities. We're going to sow prayers into their lives. And I assure you, it will gladden your heart when you begin to see the result of your prayers this morning. Let's pray. Father, thank you. Wonderful time again in your presence. And we ask that you grant unto us a spirit of supplication as we intercede on the account of our elders. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Now, Daddy has been so gracious this morning, I put together for us about 12 powerful prayer points, all right, for our elders. And I'm just going to be, you know, rolling out those prayer points, and you and I is going to agree together, and we're going to be praying it into the lives of our elders. I assure you, testimonies will begin to come when we finish these prayers, in Jesus' name. The memory verse, for example, Deuteronomy 34, verse 7. Deuteronomy 34, verse 7. And Moses was 120 years old. Glory to God. When he died, I see you with long life in Jesus' name. His eyes was not dim, nor his natural force abated. Wow. So it's not just having long life, but spending your years sickness-free, disease-free. Hallelujah. Not enduring old age, but enjoying old age. Praise God. Now, the Bible reading for today is Isaiah 46, two verses there, verse 3 and 4. Isaiah 46, 3 and 4, it says, "Hearken unto me, O house of Jacob, and all the remnant of the house of Israel, which are born by me from the belly, which are carried from the womb." Verse 4. "And even to your old age I am he, and even to hoar hairs," meaning gray hairs, will I carry you. "I have made and I will bear, even I will carry and will deliver you." God is saying, straight away there, that from your cradle to the days of your gray hair, he said he will carry you. Praise God. So the promise of God, we're going to stand on that, on the account of our elders. The Lord, you promised that even to their old age, you will yet do them good. You will carry them. You are the Ancient of Days. Praise God. So we're going to talk to the one who is older than the oldest. We're going to commit our elders into his able hands, that he will carry them. So Daddy has put together Our Father and the Lord has put together 12 prayer points, and we're going to be taking them quickly. Are you ready? Right there. All right, the first prayer point, brother and sister, it says, Father, you're going to say, Father, thank you for our elders. Thank you for giving them long life. Will you say that? Will you pray that? Father, we thank you for our elders. Oh, thank you for giving them long life. You are the giver of life. You are the giver of long life. We thank you for the length of days. We praise your name. We worship you. We thank you for the long life that you have given our elders. Oh, hallelujah, we thank you. We thank you for preserving their lives this far. It can only be you. We are grateful, and we bless your name, oh God, for that. We appreciate you, God, for keeping them alive till this day. We are looking at them, we are rejoicing. And we thank you, Father, for sparing them for us. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name, amen. Second prayer point says, Father, let our elders never lack divine wisdom to counsel and to guide the younger generation. That is very important. The Lord will supply them the wisdom. The Bible said, the one who lack wisdom, let him ask. Is our God that giveth abundantly and he upbraideth not? Let's ask God concerning our elders, that the Lord will endow them with wisdom, divine wisdom. They need it so that they can guide us aright in the ways of God. They can counsel us. They can guide the younger generation. Let's pray. Let's talk to God. Lord, we pray for your wisdom upon our elders. The wisdom that the enemy cannot gainsay. The wisdom of God upon their lives, oh Father. You said when we lack wisdom, let us ask. Father, we are asking in faith, oh God, on the account of our elders. Please endow them with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, that they will be able to counsel and guide the younger generation. In the name of Jesus, Father, we pray, oh God, grant unto them that which is required to lead the young ones, oh God, aright. Those ones who are looking up to them for direction, Father, I pray, Lord, that they will not go disappointed. In the name of Jesus Christ, thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, amen. The third prayer point is, Father, please forgive our elders for whatsoever they might have done to displease or sin against you. That's very important. Remember Eli, the prophet, the priest, at his old age, he erred. He went into error. He sinned against the Lord concerning his children. Why don't we pray for these elders? That God, please forgive them. Forgive them. Whatever they may have done in error, Lord, forgive. By the blood, plead the blood of the Lamb on the account. Father, we plead the blood of the Lamb on the account of our elders. Lord, in whatever way they may have sinned against you, please have mercy. Forgive because of the blood of your Son. Wipe away this transgression, O God, in the name of Jesus. Do not put this in their account. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, please forgive, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Number four, he said, Father, let our elders enjoy divine health. In the mighty name of Jesus, let them not endure. There are old people that, yes, they are old, but their children are just taking them from one hospital to another. They are not even enjoying. So some of them are even wishing that they could die. Let's pray for our elders. The Lord bless them with good health. Oh, hallelujah. Bless them with good health. Let all the organs of their body, know the touch of God. Let's pray. Father, we pray for our elders. Lord, bless them with good health, with vitality, with vigor, in the name of Jesus. On a daily basis, Lord, bless them with long life. Bless them with good health, in the name of Jesus. Let them not be liability elders, but let them be elders that are, Lord, as we, the testimony of Moses, Lord, let it be found in their lives also. Bless them, oh God, with good health, in Jesus' name. Number five said, Father, please send help to every elder who does not have someone to take care of him or her. Wow. Didn't you see how important that prayer point is? Father, please send every elder who does not have someone to take care of. Let's remember our widows right now. Let's pray for them. The Lord, you are the husband of the widow. Lord, we are praying that you will send help, oh God, to all our elders Oh God, who don't have no one to take care of them. Father, please, Lord, in your own miraculous way, provide for them, meet their needs, oh God. In the name of Jesus, please raise help for them, Father. Raise help, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. He said, Father, let our elders serve you for the rest of their lives. Let them fulfill your purpose for their lives. What a prayer point. Let them serve you for the rest of their lives. Let them speak as in the order of Joshua. As for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord. Let's pray. Father, we pray for our elders. The Lord, the rest of their lives, help them to serve you. For the rest of their lives, help them, O God. They are not of them that will draw back. They will walk, they will not be weary. They will run, they will not be tired. They will mount with wings as eagle. In the days of their old age, O God, help them to continue to flourish in the court of our God. In the name of Jesus, help them to serve you to the end, to fulfill your purpose for their lives. In the name of Jesus, help them to fulfill destiny. In the name of Jesus. We're going to pray, Father, let us not disappoint our elders. Let's pray that prayer, that we will not disappoint our elders. Let us make them proud, so they will have peace in their old age. The Bible says that concerning Esau, the son of Isaac, the Bible says, he did what is grievous in the heart of his father. Concerning Hophni and Phinehas, the Bible said they were grieved of heart to Eli. I want us to pray that the Lord will help us all, that we will not be children that cause shame to our elders, so that they will have peace in their old age. Let's pray. And if you are a young one and you are listening to me, what a very, very relevant prayer right there. Pray and say, God help me, that I will be a joy of heart. John said, I have no greater joy than to see my children walking in the light. These elders, they need to see us walking in the ways of God, walking in integrity, making them proud, making them happy for the rest of the days of their life. Father, we pray, help us, oh God, that we will not be grieved of heart, oh God, to these elders, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Help us not to disappoint them. Number eight, say, Father, let our elders finish strong. Let them make it to heaven when their time is up here on earth. I mean, this is this prayer. Father, we pray. Lord, let's pray quickly. Father, we pray that, Lord, make our elders to finish strong. Let them finish strong, oh God. It's not the beginning, it's the end. Help them to finish strong. In the name of Jesus, that, oh Lord, they will finish strong and afterward be received to glory. In the name of Jesus Christ. Another prayer point. Father, let our elders not lack faithful successor, who will be greater than they and will carry their legacy to the next generation. Lord, faithful successor. No success without a successor. Lord, help our elders. Lord, bless them with faithful successor that will be able to carry, oh God, the legacy to the next generation. That we won't be able, Lord, give them their Elisha with double portion. In the name of Jesus. We're going to pray, Father, help me to be a blessing to the elders in my family, in the church, in my community. What a prayer. Help me to be a blessing. I, for one, to be a blessing to my elders, the elders in my family, in my church, in my community. Go ahead and pray that prayer. Father, help me. Today, I ask of you, help me to be a blessing to my elders. In the name of Jesus, the one in my family, the one in my community, the one in my church, in the name of Jesus. Now, go ahead and mention the names of the elder in your family, in your church, in your community. Pray for them specifically. Mention their name before the Lord. Now, stand in the place of a priest and offer intercession on their behalf. Mention them, Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we mention, oh God, the elders. Lord, yes, we mention, oh God, the elders in our family, in their Dejimi family right now. I mention the elders in that family. Father, I'm praying that, Lord, make them strong. Lord, encourage them. Bless them with good health. In the name of Jesus, raise help for them in the areas of their needs. In the name of Jesus, in my church, oh God. Lord, I commit all these elders, oh God. Bless them. And finally, any special prayer you wish for yourself and your elders, we have just a few minutes. Quickly, go ahead and mention that. Special prayers, specific prayers for yourself and the elders. Go ahead and pray. Pray also that the Lord also will make you, will give you good long life, good health, long life, that you also will be named among the elders in the days to come. That you will not die young. In the name of Jesus, Father, I pray, Lord, preserve my life also. In the name of Jesus, give me long life. In the name of the Lord, will long life satisfy me and show me your salvation. In the name of Jesus. Now, that in the Lord bless us by saying, he said, I stand in agreement with you today and pray that the Lord will grant you all your requests concerning our elders in the mighty name of Jesus. That what a blessing. So our daddy is saying today that yes, he's agreeing with us in faith that all the prayers that we have prayed today, that heaven will receive it and answer us accordingly. The action point for today says, commit to always show love, care, and appreciation to elders around you, even if you are one yourself. If you are one yourself, appreciate elders. And if you are just younger, appreciate the elders, because that is a sure way for you also to have honor and to live long in life. The Lord bless you. Thank you for being with us today. May the Lord make your way prosperous today and give you good comfort in the name of Jesus. God bless you. Amen and amen.
Let it rain. Let it rain.